Hello everyone, I'm Krasia Tasio, and this is my update on the Astro Magic, on the astrological talismans that will be made, that I will be making in the month of January. Such video I'm making because I was requested to, and also the important thing is that such videos I make only when relevant, because not every month is appropriate for the creation of powerful astrological talismans. My last update for you was made in the month of October, and at that time I was updating you for the making, I think, of lunar talismans, Aldebaran talismans for improving luck and wealth, and also Algo, the Medusa talismans, which are for protection against evil eye and bad sorcery or bad influences. So what is, I would just remind you, since it was quite some time ago, what is this? What is the Astro Magic? Just very briefly, I will describe it. The Astro Magic was used since the most ancient times that you can imagine. We as far as we know, it comes from ancient Babylon, like 5000 BC. This is how far we can see, but it was probably even behind. So the Astro Magic is the royal art of astrology without any exaggeration, because in the ancient times, the royal figures would make use of the astral magic performed by astrological priests with their knowledge in order to achieve what they want. And this would be improving luck, protection, wealth, love, health, whatever you have in mind. And our sources, as I told you, go as far as in ancient Mesopotamia. Now, also to remind you that when you see the royal crowns, the gemstones that you see on the royal crowns are not just there for the sake of beauty, they are all consecrated for in appropriate celestial moment, in appropriate celestial election, and they are consecrated for certain royal purposes for the royal figures. Now, of course, in the Roman time, the Byzantium time, this was also very popular, also in the medieval times and so on and so on. I will not go into so much details because the purpose of this video is to update you on the celestial conditions in January for the creation of powerful astrological talismans. And I will tell you which they are. And they are something very, very unique. It is something that we'll be waiting for 12 years to come. And this election is coming now in January, partially also in February, but in February I will update you. For February elections, I will update you in January. So what is happening is that how we're creating the astrological talismans, you can see on my, under this video, there is a link to our school of astrology. There are also some videos on astro magic, but briefly I will tell you, the astrological talismans are, they are kind of like a package of astrological knowledge, knowledge of natural sciences, and also the moral values, like a first maybe of the astrologer, because this is knowledge that we are obliged and supposed to use only for good purposes, only for helping, only for supporting someone's health, good luck, love life, a financial situation, and never, I repeat, for harming others. So these are the three important conditions, rules, and yes. So what is happening is that, first of all, the astrological talisman is made as a combination of the qualities of the astrologer, moral and knowledge-based qualities, of course. It is so that you use appropriate herbs, and I have separate video on the herbs. If you go on my playlist on my YouTube channel on astrological talismans, you will see I'm explaining also how to collect the herbs, because every talisman which is made in order to invoke certain planetary or stellar spirit is made as a combination of the herb, appropriate election on the sky when the planet or the star is highly dignified, really highly dignified, Then it is made with the appropriate oils, which are also extracted on a very appropriate moment. And both herbs and oils need to fit the nature and the color and so many things of the planet or the star. And then, of course, is the metal, and then is the gemstone. Also about the gemstones, I have separate video. And the gemstones need to be appropriate for the planet or the star. And most important, they need to be untreated, unheated, natural. No way to use laboratory created or fake gemstones or such that are being heated or colored or whatever, or irradiated. So it's a very responsible thing to use the appropriate gemstone, the appropriate metal which fits the planet, the appropriate herb, the appropriate oil, the appropriate qualities, which would say never to deviate from the moral values and to use the knowledge of astral magic for bad purposes. And also, of course, to fast 10 days before every election, so that you really to be approved by the spirit world, so that the spirit that you are invoking of the planet to arrive and make these talismans or amulets to work. Talismans are the ones that we use for achieving our goals and desires. Amulets, like the ones that I made in October and November of the Medusa, are the ones that I use for protective purposes. Protection usually would mean protecting ourselves against evil eye or against sorcery, black magic, jealousy, bad energetic influences of others, just name it. Appear on many, many levels. And we are not allowed to make revenge. It is only protection. So this is basically and very roughly what it is all about. And in January, I will show you in a second the astrological chart of the election that I will make for creation of powerful Jupiterian talismans. Before that, I will explain what it is about. Jupiter is a planet that stays in one astrological sign, as we know, 1 year. And only once in 12 years, Jupiter enters his own astrological sign, Sagittarius. Of course, Pisces is as well ruled by Jupiter, but I feel that because Jupiter is ruled by, is a diurnal planet, his rulership over Sagittarius has a bit more powerful and royal meanings. I'm not denying absolutely that a planet that talismans made while Jupiter is in Pisces will be good, but I kind of feel that the powers of Jupiter in Sagittarius are just amazing. So as you know, now in November, beginning of November, Jupiter entered his own sign of Sagittarius, but then he became invisible. And before I show you the chart, just to explain you 2 words about the power of this specific amazing election. So Jupiter became invisible and will be invisible up until approximately 20th of January. So during his invisibility, his nature is changed, he's not the same, and you can see my other video, I'm explaining about the invisibility of Jupiter. It's just a video that I made like 2-3 days ago or a week ago. So we cannot use, even though he will be in his own sign, we cannot use his powers while he is invisible. But we can certainly use his powers when he just appears visible, like, because this is equal to his symbolic of birth, like he is just born, full of potentials, full of powers. Not only he is just born, but he is born in his own sign, and the moon is making harmonious aspect with Jupiter. And I will show you this selection. So what is happening is this, that in this very moment, while Jupiter is powerful and on mid-heaven, I will be performing ancient Babylonian white ritual, Jupiterian ritual, to create powerful astrological talismans from the collection of, as I said, appropriate herb, oil, metal, gemstone, which creates the piece of jewelry, and also, of course, the ritual that I am familiar with, following very, very ancient rules, which certainly work. So let me share my screen with you to show you the chart and to keep explaining you before I continue with the second election that I will also make in January. So this is the chart of the election of the Jupiter talismans, and you see here that Jupiter is on the 10th house on mid-heaven, and Jupiter is in his morning first, which would say that he's just born from the rays of the sun, very powerful, very potent, full of blessing and power. And also, as you can see, Jupiter is almost 10 because he's ruling the whole chart. He's at his highest dignities. He's the king. It is the day of Jupiter. Mid-heaven passes through term of Jupiter. The ascendant is ruled by sign of Jupiter. The moon is in a sign of Jupiter. The ascendant passes through Jupiterian term. The moon is in a term of Jupiter. It's all about Jupiter. It's absolutely amazing election. And the moon is creating a applying aspect to Jupiter. It's all about Jupiter. So it's a really, really brilliant election. And what is Jupiter about? I forgot to say, maybe I said briefly, but Jupiter is abundance, protection, royal power, childbearing, philosophical knowledge, value system, justice, good luck, wealth. Jupiter is the best benefic. He's just gorgeous. It's really one time in 12 years when we can have the opportunity for creation of Jupiterian talismans. So also you can see that this, even though he will be 1 year in his own sign, he entered in November and he will be in his own sign until end of November 2020, you will see that actually there will be only one or two opportunities to make such talismans. One will be in January and another one in February, and I will update you additionally on the one in February. But why only then? Because you will see that Mars is approaching to enter Sagittarius to ruin the election, because when Mars is there, we can't make Jupiterian talismans. Another thing is that Ketu is there, but Ketu is not ruining the election. Ketu is quite far now from Jupiter, but Ketu is the only planet that can deal with Ketu, and Rahu is Jupiter. So Ketu is not endangering the election. But even if he does, the distance is quite good. But Mars will be entering to destroy the election. So we have only two opportunities to create such astrological talismans. You can make use of my election, but keep in mind, it's 30th of January, the election, that this is for my European longitudes and latitudes. And for your own coordinates, you may need to adjust the time of the election. But still, the date can be a very good indication for you. So this is about Jupiter. As I said, there will be a link under this video where you can see the link to my beautiful astrological talismans of Jupiter, which will be consecrated in January 2020. And now I will share my screen to show the next election. But let me tell you two words about the next election. It will be about Mars. Mars is a malefic planet. To make Martian talismans is tricky because Mars is a malefic planet, and it's not, such talismans are not for everyone. Such talismans can be for people whose Mars is not afflicting a luminary, for example, to harm their body. So very much depends on the placement of Mars in their natal charts. For example, Mars can be a wonderful talisman if in your chart is visible that Mars is not harming any other planet, first of all, because once you make a talisman of Mars and you wear it, and Mars is afflicting other planet or luminary in your chart, then his afflicting powers can be increased. So the Martian talisman is not for everyone. It is for people who have invisible Mars. With this invisible Mars, they may have some issues related to stand up for themselves and for having drive to complete tasks, to complete issues, having drive to defend themselves, to have this healthy Martian ambition sometime when it's not over rated, it's good. So the Martian talismans, I said, depend on the natal chart of the person, of each person. So in case that you feel need of Martian talisman and you first better contact me with your birth chart so that I see if really Martian talisman is about you. In some cases, invisible Mars in people's chart can create sexual issues, can create issues with partnerships. So Mars is a very important planet to be present in the chart. But in cases when he's afflicting, then it's better not to touch this planet by using astrological talisman, because the astrological talismans are also powerful remedies in terms of health, improving conditions in the chart which need improvement. So they are really remedies. In this sense, when it comes to Mars and Saturn, it's always good first to get advice from astrologer before deciding to where or such talisman to be made for you. However, let me share my screen with you to show you. All right, look at my electional chart. It is for 1st of January. Now look what we have here. Mars is in his Martian term in the sign of Scorpio. Why here I chose in particular Mars to be in the 11th house? It's because it's the mid-heaven place, and there is another very specific reason. The 11th house is called the house of the good spirit. And when we put malefic planets in the 11th house, then the features of the planet are softened, become more beautiful, become benefic to a degree. We can't change completely the nature of Mars, and we don't want this, but his nature will be very nice when in the 11th house. Will be better. Then we have the mid-heaven passing through the 7th degree. You see, this is the 7th degree of Scorpio, and the 7th degree of Scorpio is hermetic degree, very much about knowledge and good things, can bring a very good knowledge, healing, secret studies, knowledge, and intuitive stuff. And it's a very good placement. And then you can see that the ascendant is also Capricorn, which is the hidden place of Mars, and Venus is on the ascendant. So this looks like pretty good election for creation of Martian talismans. But once again, these talismans are not for everyone. So they will be on my website soon, and you can consult my website also for Martian talismans. But as I say, it has to fit the personal chart. Though when we're talking about Jupiter is good for absolutely everyone. It's even wonderful. The Jupiter talismans can bring blessing and good luck and joy to everyone. With Mars and Saturn, this is not exactly the case. So I hope this was useful. Thank you for your attention. Your questions are welcome. And yes, see you again. And I will also share with you soon the way I made when I was making the algal amulets for protection. I will share with you, I will make a video filming my ritual space, when I will show you how I'm putting together the herbs with oils, with all features or all details which take part in my Jupiterian astral magic. So thank you for your attention. See you soon.